Hello and welcome to this video where I'm going to show you how to connect your Mendeley account to your Overleaf account. I'll start by going over why both Mendeley and Overleaf are great tools when you're writing academically. I would also like to mention though that this feature is only available if you have an Overleaf professional account. So if you don't have that, this feature simply will not work. However, if you are a student, try to ask your university if they provide Overleaf professional accounts, as many of them do. So Overleaf is an online LaTeX and rich text collaborative writing tool that simplifies the entire process of writing, editing, and publishing scientific documents. And with this tool, you can write LaTeX documents, compile them, and work on them in real time with your fellow academics. Personally, I've used this throughout my entire university education and found it immensely useful for producing pretty reports and all sorts of other fancy documents. A great benefit of the tool is that you don't have to install any local LaTeX editing tools. You simply go to the website, create a document, and start writing. Mendeley is a reference managing software from Elsevier that can help you get an overview of all the citations you use in your projects. It allows to import from various sources as well as export to various formats. On top of that, it has a Chrome and Safari extension that will automatically generate citations for the specific PDF or website you have open in your browser. You can then take those citations and group them into groups in Mendeley that fit the specific project. In Overleaf, you can then create an Overleaf project, link it to that Mendeley group, and then you'll always have an updated list of references while you're writing. Overleaf also has Zotero integration, which is a similar reference manager to Mendeley. I simply choose Mendeley because it provides 2 GB of free cloud storage, where Zotero only provides 300 megabytes. And on top of that, Mendeley both has a desktop app and a Safari extension, whereas Zotero only has a web extension. Before we start, make sure that you have both an Overleaf and Mendeley account. If you don't, simply head over to overleaf.com or mendeley.com, hit register, and fill out the associated information. Once you have an Overleaf and Mendeley account, head over to Overleaf and click on Account and then Settings. Then scroll down until you see the Reference Managers section. Click on Link next to Mendeley, and then it'll ask you to log in. So I'll just log in, and that's it, we're done. Your Mendeley account is now connected to your Overleaf account. With everything now set up, we can test it out. So if you head over to overleaf.com and click on New Project, then Blank Project, and give it a name. Then Overleaf will create us a document, and then we need to include the BibliTeX package to be able to use the referencing system. And then we'll write some random text like this is a test, and then reference a test reference. And then finally print the list of references. So if we compile this, we'll see that nothing really shows because we don't have any references at all. So let's create some. To create a citation, we'll use the Mendeley Safari extension. If you don't have it yet, I'll leave a link in the description below to where you can get it. So we'll start by going to mendeley.com. and then open up the library. And down here in the groups, we'll create a new group called test. That has been created, so we'll Google something like how does ChatGPT work, and we'll look for Medium article. If we open this article here, and we click on the Mendeley Safari extension up here, then we can see it's already generated the content for us. You can also edit it if you like, so we can see it hasn't included the author, for example, or the year that it was published, or the month or day. So now we choose where we want to add this, and we add it to our private group test, and just click Add, and now we have a citation. We can now head over to Mendeley, and go to our private group test, and we can see that it's added the citation here. And if we click on it, we'll need to give it a citation key to be able to reference it in Overleaf, so we called it test reference. We can also see that Mendeley has automatically inferred what type of citation it is. In this case, it's a web page. However, if you're quoting a scientific article, you can choose a journal article here, for example. It doesn't always get this right, so do check if it does this right, but most of the time, it's pretty accurate. Now that we have a citation, we can add it into our Overleaf project. So if we head back to Overleaf, click on the Upload button, and then on the From Mendeley button, it'll show us a list of the groups that we have connected through Mendeley. So we'll choose our test group and just leave the file name as default and hit create. So what it's done for us now is create this references.bib file, which contains a BibTeX reference of the citation we just added to Mendeley. Now to use this in our LaTeX document, we need to use the add bib resource command and put in the references.bib file, and then change this ref to cite to correctly cite the citation. Now, if we recompile this, we'll see that it's correctly imported the reference into LaTeX and even printed the list of references. So there you have it. That's just how easy it is to connect your Mendeley account to your Overleaf account. And as a last piece of bonus information, I wanted to show you how to divide your references section into subsections depending on the type of references you have. So I found a journal article about is ChatGPT a good translator, just as an example. And then I'll add this reference to our test group in Mendeley. There we go. And then I'll head back over to Mendeley, give it a name, just say translation. And then if we go back to our Overleaf document, update our references, we'll see that it's now fetched this new reference. And then to divide our references section into subsections, we'll firstly create a section that's just called references. And then to divide the bibliography into subsections, we give it the input of heading equals sub in talk, comma type, and then we have, this was an article, so we write article, and then we give it the title of articles. And then we had the original test reference, which is of a MISC type, so we do the same thing, we write print bibliography, heading equals sub in talk. Yeah, and then the type in this case is a MISC type, and then the title is equal to web pages. Let's just put a equal sign there. And then if we compile this and spell this correctly, then we'll see that it's actually divided our references into subsections. And to include the other one, we just write cite translation, and then it should divide our references into subsections depending on the type of reference that we're using. So thank you for watching. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please hit the subscribe button below and let me know in the comments if you have any questions.